Hey everyone, my name is Nick Chalon. I'm the former Chief Software Officer for the Air Force and Space Force. And today we're gonna finally find out what Kubernetes is all about. So we're finally moving away from monolithic architectures to microservices. You're gonna be adopting containers. You're gonna be thinking differently. You're cutting your systems, you're cutting your application. You wanna be more efficient. You wanna be able to cut into pieces so you can finally have a decoupling between teams. You want to scale, you want to move fast. So the issue you see when you start adopting microservices is you're increasing complexity. Now your team have to run all these containers and make sure they're not crashing, which container is going to be talking to what container, so you can mitigate and reduce your attack surface. You're going to be thinking cattle versus pets. With the virtual machines, we call them pets. You want to keep it healthy. You give it a name. You want to make sure it's up and running. With containers, you think differently. It's cattle. You want to shoot it behind the barn every 4 hours to go back to your mutable state. It's increasing your cyber posture. So now that you're moving to containers, you're going to enable the decoupling of your team so they can release at their own pace and move at a pace of relevance. That's critical. You want to be able to scale up and down microservices based on the traffic, memory needs, CPUs. You also want to bring security and continuous monitoring with logs and telemetry aggregation. But when you start moving to this very complex architecture of microservices, completely containerized, now you have an issue. You need to orchestrate these containers. You need to heal them when they crash. You need to scale them up and down. You need to do the routing and load balancing and access ingress and egress and east-west traffic. That's where Kubernetes is finally bringing its value. Google created Kubernetes and donated it to the Cloud Native Computing Foundation, the CNCF. Kubernetes is an abstraction layer. It enables you to decouple through the Kubernetes API your application from cloud providers. And you can effectively host your application anywhere. That's a massive value for organizations that need to run their software at the edge on different cloud providers and also not get locked into a single cloud provider. So Kubernetes embraced the notion of desired state. Everything is in code, declarative, in your source code repo that enables infrastructure as code, configuration as code, and even GitOps. So Kubernetes is like the maestro for your container, a container orchestration stack. It has multiple benefits. The first piece is it brings resiliency thanks to self-healing of the containers and thanks to the ability to scale up and down your containers based on the traffic needs, whether it's compute or memory. Now, Kubernetes also brings baked-in security thanks to a concept called cycle containers. We're not going to have the time to get into that, but we're going to be covering that in the next video. So everything in Kubernetes works with an API, the Kube API, and has a control plane and nodes. It's also capable of auto-scaling your nodes in Kubernetes to be able to spin up more nodes, to be able to run more containers so you can scale as well. So additionally, a benefit of using infrastructure as code, configuration as code, and GitOps is your ability to instantiate a replica of your stack at any time and treat your entire infrastructure as cattle. That's a massive cyber benefit. So there's a tremendous talent gap when it comes to Kubernetes. So if you want to start learning and investing in yourself, you need to take a look at the CNCF certifications. So some of the certification you should take a look at are the Certified Kubernetes Application Developer, the Certified Kubernetes Security Specialist, but also the Certified Kubernetes Administrator as well. Thanks for watching. Please subscribe. Make sure you click that bell button to get notifications, and we'll see you in the next video.